So what's actually pre-construction means, and what are the pros and cons of investing in pre-construction? So many people have asked me what the heck is pre-construction investing is, and what are the positives of investing in pre-construction? What are some negatives? You know, what are the cons, pros and cons of investing in pre-construction? So stay tuned. In this video, I'll be clarifying all those things. And also, you know, I'll be sharing my side of story, why I purchased. I have two pre-construction that I bought in last 1 year. So stay tuned. Namaskar, welcome back to my channel. This is Aditya Soma. I'm a real estate investor and real estate agent here in Windsor, Ontario. And also I have a team of professionals who are realtors, you know, called Wind City Real Estate Team here in Windsor, Ontario, where we help investors, you know, buyers, sellers to, you know, make their investment journey smooth. So if you haven't been following me, that's my story. But if you've been following me, I would like to ask you a small favor, especially if you like my content. Make sure you smash that like button because that helps my channel to reach more people. So with that, let's get into this today's topic, which is pre-construction. So first of all, what's really pre-construction is? So basically, pre-construction means you're investing into a project, into a detached home or semi-detached home or townhome or condominium, high-raised or low-raised, whatever the type of property is, you're buying that property, but it's not built yet. So as of now, you have a paper of contract with a builder saying that you're buying this particular piece of property on so-and-so date for so-and-so price of, you know, as per the current market value, but this particular property will be built after 2 years or 3 years or 4 years. It depends on the builder, on their plan. So there will be an actual occupancy date. So that happens in future. So as of now, all you have is a contract to prove that you are the homeowner of that particular property that to be built. So that's why it's called pre-construction investment. So you're investing into this project before the construction happened. So let's keep that aside. Hope that, you know, you understand that way, the definition. But, you know, what it means for you as an investor, what are some positives, why people invest? You know, I have a good friend and partner who actually made millions just through investing. And he's the one actually, the reason I got into pre-construction. And I'll you know, put his story links in the other video that where, you know, he shared his story, why he got into pre-construction, all those things. Check out that video. But in the meanwhile, you know, he was the one who was always telling me about this pre-construction. I didn't bought into it until a year ago when, you know, my business started to be super busy. And, you know, I have no time for running around doing the renovations, taking care of renovations, or, you know, and I have my business started to grow where I have a little bit more money saved in my account. I want to put that money into action. So that's when, like, I started to, you know, really take his suggestion seriously. That's when I started to learn more about pre-con. So the first pro that I feel why a lot of people get into pre-construction, and especially why I got in as well, was with this pre-constructions, there is no hassle. What I mean by that, you don't have any tenants, you don't need to do any renovations, you don't have to, you know, manage your tenants, no maintenance, nothing, because there is no project at all, there is no property built at all until you take possession. So that could be, you know, 2 years down the road or 3 years down the road or 4 years down the road. Until then, you're more like banking on the market appreciation. So you're putting this money and it's just growing in value. So that was one of the biggest aha moment for me, because, you know, since just in last one and a half year, my business started to become, you know, growing a little bit more, and I have to give more attention. I could not spend same energy where I used to spend before on my all my burr strategies, all my active projects. But again, at the same time, I want my money to grow. So that was one of the major reasons. And number two was, you know, I don't need all the money at once. So what I mean by that, when you're buying resale property, let's say you're buying a property for 600,000, you need 20% down, which is 120,000 right away upfront at the closing, which is like 1 month down the road or 2 months down the road. That's a typical closing for resale. So on that closing day, you need all this money. But for pre-construction, you don't need that. You know, a lot of people I know, you know, who are like just starting their career, they only have 20,000 or 30,000, or, you know, there are a lot of people who are, they don't even have that, but they know that they will be getting more money in next 6 months or 10 months, or they're saving in phases. So this pre-constructions are fantastic to save, and it will force you to save the money in phase. So the recent pre-construction I purchased, here is the deposit structure they have. So on the day I purchased that contract, I have to pay 5,000, and within 30 days I have to pay like total of 5%, including that 5K. So I purchased, for example, let's take a number, 600,000 property. I need to pay 5% in total in first 30 days, which is 30,000, and then next 30,000, next 5%, I will get another 5 months time period. So I can save money, I can do extra work or whatever, and I can save this money in that 5 months, and then another 2.5% in next 4 months after that 5 months. So now I got more time to save some more money, 15,000, and then I get another 4 months from there for another 15,000, and I get, you know, pretty much the other 5% I have to pay at the end of closing. So I have time to bring the money. That was like aha moment, you know, because there are a lot of people who don't do investments because they feel like they don't have enough money. Because in general, resale, you need 20% down. So that would be a solid positive for many people. And third positive, this is another aha moment. You don't need to qualify for a mortgage, or you don't need a mortgage at the time of purchase. Yes, you heard it right. Because whereas resale property, when you're buying it, you need to qualify for the property, and you need to have your deposit ready in your account from last 2 months or 3 months saved in your account. In this case, it's not the case. You don't have to. You know, maybe your qualification will go up in next 6 months or 7 months. If the pre-construction is closing after 4 years, you got plenty of time to be qualified for that mortgage, plenty of time to save money for that. So that's a cool thing. You don't have to qualify for the mortgage right away. If you, all you need to be qualified is when the closing happens. When the closing happens, you need to be able to get secure the mortgage. And again, there is a way, even if you don't qualify at that time, you can still make the profit, which is, you know, that leads to my fourth benefit, which is like, you know, even at that time you don't qualify, you just assign your contract to someone else. Which means, you know, if you haven't heard what assignment is, you're literally, you have this contract, right? Which is saying that you will be closing this particular property in X in 2024. And when the closing date is approaching and you know that you don't qualify for mortgage, now all you need to do is find a buyer, or you need to ask your realtor, just, hey, find me another buyer. Now you have sat on this contract for 4 years. If in this 4 years, you bought this property for 600,000, and the property appreciated for 200,000 in next 4 years, which we all know in Ontario, especially Canada, is, you know, with this population increase, there is a likely high chances for, you know, that kind of appreciation. So 4 years down the road, you made this 200,000. Now you say to the buyer, hey, I'll give it to you for 750,000 instead of 800. The property on the market is 800,000, but I'll give you 750. So you make that 150 profit with investing that 15% in that 2-3 years, you made 15% of 600,000, approximately 90,000, and you sold this contract for 150,000. So you made approximately 200% return on your money by not qualifying, no tenants, no renovations, no mortgage required, right? So how cool is that? Think about it. And another positive that we touched a little bit in the previous one, which is like, you know, your property is more likely to appreciate because, you know, it's a brand new home that is going to be built 4 years from the down the road. So the appreciation is almost kind of guaranteed. And the last positive that I feel is like, you know, because this is the home that is to be built in future, you're getting modern updates, you know, you're getting more like a better features because it's brand new and it will be built at that time. Okay, Aditya, that's fantastic. You know, you're talking about all the nice roses and flowers, right? But I heard some, you know, not so good things about the pre-construction investing. So what do you think about them? So here are some of the, you know, negative side of the pre-construction investing is, again, you know, in my personal opinion. So the number one is you cannot access your money until the closing happens, you know, once you got into the contract. Because even if you assign the deal for someone else, let's say after 1 year, but your closing is in 2024, now you're locked up, your money is locked up until then. Yes, you will be making profits, whereas in the resale, you know, you can go do the work and refinance and pull your money out within 6 months and 1 year. Whereas pre-construction, so for the pre-construction money that I spent before, I cannot take them out right now. I can only, you know, access them 4 years down the road. So again, that's in my opinion for an investor's, you know, for some of them it's a positive, some of them it's a negative. So definitely I want to bring that up for you. You are the only one who can judge if it's a positive for you or not. And the second con that I see is, especially, you know, the pre-constructions means they are brand new homes, right? So after the closing, after 2024, let's say from our previous example, you're closing this property in 2024. So after that, because it's a brand new home, because you purchased for, you know, again, you paid the price of new construction. So most likely the property might not cash flow, because, you know, generally the newer homes are always high price and your cash flow might be less. Again, this is the reason where my strategy of buying the pre-construction, the reason I'm buying is I'm not gonna go do buy and hold with them. I'm gonna have this contract until end of 2024. Either I assign it for profit or I will take position. Maybe I'll move into that project for 6 months and I sell it with no capital gain and take my profit. Or again, you know, my financial situation might change. You know, I'm okay with having a negative cash flow when I have, you know, surplus of income coming in. Maybe again, I don't know at that point, but I have multiple exit strategies. So that was the con, which is like, yes, there is high chances of low cash flow or no cash flow, but I'm avoiding that with a different strategy. And the last con that I feel like, you know, one of the concerns that I got from many people, and even myself, I had this negative thing, which is like, you know, there is a risk of what if the project never get built, and what if the builder gets into, you know, what do you call, bankruptcy? So now you lost your money. So yes, that's definitely, there is a risk. That's exactly why, number one, you gotta do your due diligence, which builder you're buying into, because very, very, very important, the credibility of the builder. Because again, here's the thing, at the end, you're investing. No investment comes with risk. Like every investment has a risk. So same thing, what do you do to mitigate your risk? You do your due diligence and buy into good projects, like solid builder who has like years of experience, who has a good reputation in the industry. Those are the one I'm buying into. So again, yes, but again, at the end, there is a risk of the builder not finishing it, a risk of having some kind of a legal things, you know, the builders put some unnecessary legal stuff at the end, the time of closing. So just make sure you're buying into good, solid builder's projects. So that's where I will wrap up this pros and cons. But again, if I missed something, if you are been investing in pre-construction, let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are. I love to hear other people's stories, you know, especially if you've been investing in pre-construction. And again, I'm still learning about this pre-constructions. I only have done 2 projects so far. So really open-minded to hear your thoughts. With that, thank you so much. If you love the video, smash that like button. Help me to reach more people. Have a wonderful day. Until then, check out the other videos and see you in the next video.